Welcome to Courtney's Fix, my food advice channel and place to maximize the joy in your life. Today we are talking about olives. Sharon wrote in and asked, are olives good for you? Hell yeah, olives are good for you. So we're going to really be focusing on black olives today, but before we even get into that, we're going to talk about, just for a second, the difference between black and green olives. And so they don't come on different trees. Actually, they're different levels of ripeness. So a green olive is actually less ripe than a black olive. And then sometimes you see purple ones, and sometimes you see super dark ones, and all those are just gradations of color. So we'll be having a different video on green olives, and on that one we're also gonna be making dirty martinis. So we're gonna set this one aside. So let's talk black olives. So just in terms of health, olives, are you kidding? Vitamin E up the wazoo, antioxidants, all kinds of antis. They got antioxidants, it's like anti-stress, it lowers cholesterol, anti-cancer, pre-diabetic, all the antis here. So vitamin E, I mean, you think about all the people who've just been consuming olive oil all these years. Now, in terms of black olives, so the black olives are all the way on the full ripeness spectrum. So they have a very rich flavor in them. If you'll see, they're less, they're softer than when you taste a green olive. And to me, like when you put them in your mouth, it's like, ooh, the oil just flows from them and they feel full in the mouth. The other thing, I have like four different olives here. A lot of the olives that we have here in the United States mainly come from California. There's only about maybe four different kinds of trees that have been used. A couple other ones now, but in main production. So when you go get your olives from your favorite store, unless it specifies where it's from, whether it says Greek or, you know, French picoline, or it says Nichoise or something like that, chances are it's a California olive. And then what they'll do, I left these in the plastic so you'll see, then what they'll do is they'll tell you how they've cured it or what spices they put on it. So like on this one, it says Provençal, and then it says Provençal herbs oil cured. So these are California olives that have been prepared a certain way. These other ones are Nichoise, so these are actually French olives. And then we have our Callisto Kalamatas, and these are Greek olives. And then we got other Greek olives. So that's one of the things. There's a few different ways that they get cured. You do not eat raw olives. And Lord, I want to know the person. I want to meet the person at what year of whatever century that figured it out and was like, man, these are nasty. And then who's going to cure them? But all that aside, so before we wrap it up, one of the main things I want you to think about when you go get your olives, and I have all these olives, and I just want y'all to know for you, I tasted the bar. There were ones that are not here that I didn't pay for that I tasted before I got to these best ones for you. But one of the things that I really want you to do when you go buy your olives, splurge for the liquid, splurge for the oil or the liquid to cover the olives. If you don't, they get old, they start to taste rancid. Splurge. I even read an article, one guy, what he does, he gets his olives, I'm so surprised, he gets his olives and then he goes back and asks him for the liquid. If you want to roll like that, roll, but whatever you do, leave with your liquid, or if they're oil-based, just a little bit of oil, because the oil's staying with them, and then refrigerate them.
Psst. Hey, it's Courtney. Hope you really liked the video. Beneficial foods are part of my daily I love myself formula. They feed my body, hey, sometimes just my soul. See you next time. Please press the bell below, hit like and subscribe. Comments and questions are always welcome. And remember, maximize your joy, 'cause life is fun as shit.